In a world full of relationships, it is often difficult to distinguish between healthy and unhealthy relationships. It could seem like two instead of relationships could both be happy, but is that really the case? A daddy longleg could be crawling on someone's hand, but are they really both benefiting? Or a tree? Yes, animals can live in them, but are they doing more harm than good? Now, people who do their research will know that there are three main types of relationships, but for you people who like to learn through videos, we will inform you. To start, there is a mutualism, like a friendship or healthy relationship in the animal kingdom. Both sides of the relationship benefit, such as these magnificent leafcutter ants. Look at them all working together. Now, it seems as if these ants are doing more harm to the tree because they are taking leaves. However, this is something that the ants have been doing for several years. The ants are like farmers. They take the leaves back to their colony, then grow a type of fungus on them. This fungus and the ant both benefit from each other because the fungus and the ant have been co-evolving together for generations. The fungus cannot grow without the leafcutter ants farming, and the ants use the fungus for their food source. Alongside the mutualistic relationships, there are commensalism relationships. These relationships aren't necessarily unhealthy, they're just not beneficial for both organisms. In commensalistic relationships, only one organism benefits while the other is neither harmed nor gaining benefit. Take these gigantic walking sticks, for example. They use the trees they hide in as a way to stay safe from predators by using camouflage, while the tree just kind of sits there, not caring because it's not getting hurt. As you can see, the walking sticks have evolved to thrive from this relationship. Without the trees that they live in, they couldn't thrive, and their population would likely dwindle. Imagine just seeing a walking stick walking around on a sidewalk. It's pretty obvious that they're an insect. Not only would it be obvious to us, it would be even more obvious to their predators such as primates, spiders, rodents, reptiles, birds, and bats. On the topic of predators, there is a final and unhealthy relationship, parasitism. Yes, parasitism, the most feared relationship by any innocent creature. Parasitism occurs when one organism is benefiting and the other suffers. An example of a parasitic relationship would be this wide-eyed assassin bug and its prey. You can obviously see how the assassin bug benefits. They are able to feed on the crickets they have as a food source. However, the crickets don't benefit at all because they're getting eaten and its life is over. Sometimes a relationship doesn't kill the victims instantly. The parasite could benefit for a while, then take the kill. It all depends on the different species. In summary, don't be a parasite to your partner, and make sure you know the warning signs of a parasitic relationship.